Hello, welcome to the commencement ceremony of the class of 2022. My name is Ainsley Klesko, and I'm honored to share my perspective as this year's salutatorian. As seniors, we spent many an hour around Mr. Southwick's hardness table, glancing around the bookshelf covered, poster hanging classroom, awaiting this very day. Within the maze of portables, a classroom such as this truly encapsulates Geneva's literary foundation. From the formidable entry to rhetoric school that was Homer's Iliad, the stories that line these shelves have guided us throughout the past 4 years. We have sailed across the Aegean with Odysseus, explored hell with Virgil, conjured storms with Prospero, and sat in the courthouse with Atticus. We have learned about humility through Achilles, philosophy through Prometheus, morality through Hamlet, and democracy through Plato. Around these stories, sitting in circular formation, we have expanded upon these characters and their morals in true classical fashion. Of course, navigating this world may seem daunting, a feeling which I greatly experienced as I came to the school in 8th grade. Back then, it seemed to me as if Geneva seemed to operate using its own language. The buildings were named after literary figures, Latin phrases were casually tossed about, the most knowledgeable students were experts in Greek mythology, and the Lord of the Rings franchise was worshipped. However intimidated I was on my very first day, these feelings quickly faded as I embraced becoming a part of such a distinct community full of personality. As I learned then and know now, there is truly no place like Geneva. Nowhere else would I expect to celebrate the medieval feast of St. Crispin's Day on a weekday lunch, or honor the end of sophomore year with the layer cake of Dante's Inferno. Only at Geneva would hobbit costumes and Quidditch broomsticks blend in as effortlessly as backpacks and textbooks. The quirks of our community are especially evident, and the confused looks at the mention of the term rhetoric school instead of high school, Quidditch instead of football, boardwalk instead of hallway, and thesis instead of a carefree senior year. However, literature and language alone are not what truly makes Geneva so special. The teachers, parents, and students do. Even 5,000 pages later, our beloved bookshelf fictional characters still pale in comparison to the plaid-skirted and khaki-pants students who populate the boardwalk. From chronic illnesses, car accidents, cancer, and of course COVID, the class of 2022 has prevailed for our share of hardship. From the joy that radiates from each and every student, one might never even assume the presence of hardships like these and many more left unnoticed. This steadfast joy is characteristic of our students and a testament to the environment in which it is nurtured. Nearing the end of our formative teenage years has been no easy task, on top of a demanding education. So, today is not an accomplishment that should be taken lightly. Every graduate that walks the stage has sacrificed countless hours for this very moment. We have all presented at the podium, bubbled in the answers, and written the argumentative essays. But more importantly, we have shared countless laughs, formed timeless friendships, and even discovered ourselves while supporting each other in the process. As we transition from the past to the future, today should motivate us to feel empowered in our past accomplishments and optimistic in our future capability. Reflecting on our rhetoric school experience and the amount of emotional and spiritual growth within, I can only imagine the impact the class of 2022 will continue to have. As we head off across the state of Texas and beyond, goodbyes are inevitable, besides the half of the class relocating to College Station. However, for the rest of us, our goodbyes will be expectedly tinged with sadness as we process this change. Yet, I would challenge ourselves to view these emotions in a different light, as we celebrate the opportunity to have been surrounded and shaped by such meaningful people and moments. Although seeing such familiar faces on a daily basis will be dearly missed, their impact, whether we are cognizant of their influence or not, will follow us across Texas and beyond. Even though our time along Cascade Caverns has drawn to a close, its influence has only really just begun. I'm beyond grateful to have spent the past 5 years with a group that made me feel as welcome as if I'd been here since kindergarten. Your steadfast joy, courage, and selflessness inspires countless daily and humbles even the noblest of literary figures. To our teachers, thank you for your consistent support and encouragement. Today would not be possible without you. To our families, thank you for your commitment to our future. You have made our fond experiences at Geneva a reality. To my fellow graduates, thank you for making every day so wonderful. I love each and every single one of you. And lastly, talents on forever. Thank you.